Should investors fear a China slowdown?
Well, I think when you're thinking about China, the important thing, as with most emerging markets, is to really focus on the companies. So whilst you might see a slowdown in China from a macro perspective, the important thing really is to recognize the fact that macro growth doesn't necessarily translate into stock market performance. So when you're looking at stocks in China, be more wary about the quality of the businesses and whether or not they have a sustainable business model, and whether or not the management team are there to are interested in you as a minority shareholder. And be aware that the government is often a more important stakeholder in many of the businesses than you might be. So whilst you may see a slowdown in China, you may well also see a speed up. And if China speeds up, that doesn't necessarily also mean the businesses do so well. So be wary from a stock level rather than at a macro level.
Do you still see opportunities among consumer names in Southeast Asia?
Well, I think when you look at the quality of the businesses in the consumer sector in Southeast Asia, what you'll find is some of the most compelling growth opportunities globally. And I completely agree that, you know, you've seen a re-rating of some of the consumer businesses, not just in Southeast Asia, but actually across emerging markets. But one of the things that we feel strongly about is that the growth story is still intact. And when you're in an uncertain economic environment, being able to invest in something we feel confident in is something worth paying a price for. And indeed, you often find that businesses which have a strong competitive advantage and a great long-term growth outlook can actually sustain a reasonable multiple for quite some time.
Do you see opportunities in infrastructure names among emerging markets?
Well, interestingly, the way the world is these days, the sovereign balance sheets within emerging markets are so much stronger than you find in developed markets. And of course, that means governments have a lot more money to put to play building infrastructural assets, which are seen as a primary source of economic growth, both in terms of employment and the multiplier effect it can have on GDP growth. So what we're finding is that the amount of money which governments are spending on infrastructure in emerging markets is at unparalleled levels. Now, that's a great macro theme or a great macro backdrop, but again, the focus has to be on the companies. So when you look at the companies which you're able to invest in the infrastructure space in emerging markets, you must be cognizant of how they are related to governments or other stakeholders within the economy. And interestingly, when you look at companies in the utilities sector, for example, you may find that the government has a predilection to subsidize the population. So pricing pressure is very strong in that particular sector. The same would go for telecommunications. And it's very difficult for businesses like that to pass through price increases. So you don't necessarily get the uplift in returns that you might find in other infrastructure assets. So again, I'd say the emphasis for any investor looking to invest in infrastructure in emerging markets is to look at the companies. And if you do take that stock level approach, you'll find some great opportunities in the real estate sector, in the telecommunication sector. There are some fantastic mobile businesses in Africa, for example. But also you'll find some great infrastructure assets like airports, maritime ports and so on. These are great businesses with operating leverage, which are really benefiting from the uptick in demand in emerging markets. And with that backdrop of government spending more money on infrastructure, the opportunities coming the way of these businesses are really at great levels.
Do you see opportunities in commodity countries?
You can take many countries and they're often perceived to be commodity countries. So if you take, for example, Chile or Brazil, both countries which have great mineral wealth and which people tend to see as either a copper play or an iron ore play, you have to look more deeply than that. And if you look more in depth at the market, what you'll find is a number of great consumer and domestic demand orientated stocks. So if you're willing to take a more in-depth view of these economies, in Chile, for example, there's a number of great banks to invest in. In Brazil, the same goes for the financial sector. The same goes for some of the infrastructure and consumer plays that you can find there. But you have to be willing to go down the market cap range. So some of the smaller to mid-sized businesses are perhaps more interesting than purely commodity plays.